Hey, what's up? I hope y'all had a great Thanksgiving, and it's fitting that our last Life-Giving Rhythms video rhythm in this series is giving. We studied the 10th commandment, you shall not covet, being content with what you have, and we looked at the parable that Jesus told in Matthew 20 of the laborers in the vineyard. And this whole idea of being content with what we have, knowing that we have a Father who loves us, who's always going to meet our needs, who's always going to take care of us, and that frees us up to live differently. And so just like the laborers in the vineyard, Jesus especially was talking to those who came in the first hour and were upset because they didn't get paid more than the laborers who came later. The lesson that Jesus is teaching us there, all of his followers, is that the treasure is not the payment for working. For those of us who are in Christ, the treasure is working alongside of our Father in the vineyard. That's the treasure. And so when we think that the treasure is the payment, then that leads to all sorts of issues. And we're going to miss life. We're going to miss joy. We're going to miss the good gifts that God's trying to give us. And we're going to be greedy. And we're going to try to hoard. And we're going to try to keep and we're going to try to take care of ourselves and not trust on our Father's provision. We're going to try to provide for ourselves and be independent. And so when we do that, it's like mold growing. We just have this soul rot that comes from greed, from trying to hoard everything and keep it in. We've been made to be like our Father. We were made in God's image, and God is paying people for work that they didn't do. He's paying people out of grace and out of concern for them and making sure that all their needs are met. And so he's inviting us to live that way. To follow him in that. And he's enabled us to live that way because he said, hey, you don't ever have to worry. You can always come here and be with me and have all your needs met. And so in this rhythm, there are three ways I want us to think about giving this week. Three categories, I guess. One is giving to the church. The Lord has said, this is how I want my people to think about this is the way I want my people to think about giving. This is the way I want my people to think about what it is to be the body of Christ. And he's made it to where we are all called to give to the work of the church. And that's for our health. That's for the life of the church and the ministry that we have and the way that God's going to enable that. So thinking about this week, do you give to Midtown West? And if you do, thank you. And that's for you. The Lord has a cattle. He says, the cattle on a thousand hills are mine. Translated to today is, I don't need your money, but this is more for you. I'm inviting you to financially take part in this work because it brings you joy and it's good for your heart. It keeps that soul rot from growing. And so if you've never given before, I want you to consider giving as a rhythm. And even if it's literally just a dollar a week that your heart is invested in this place that you call your church home. And so giving to your church home, and for us, that's Midtown West. The second way I want you to think about giving is there is tithing, which is that, and then there's also almsgiving, which God also expected his people to be a part of, which is giving to the poor. And so we can give to people who have specific needs. We can give to organizations, nonprofits, and ministries who serve the poor in different ways, but he wants us to take care of the people in our community who can't take care of themselves for whatever reason. And so finding ways, finding people and organizations to give to this season to meet those tangible physical needs, that would be the equivalent of almsgiving. So we've got tithing, we've got almsgiving. And then the last is just fun, just to remind us of, to get a glimpse into the joy that comes from giving. I'll just challenge you to do this week. Pick an amount of money. It can be $5, it can be $20, it can be $100, whatever you want it to be, and say, I'm setting aside this money and I'm asking the Lord, will you make it clear who to give this money to this week? And you will be amazed at how the Lord makes very clear who he wants you to give that money to. And it's such a joy to see in relationship with him and the way that you're blessing somebody else, maybe somebody you know, maybe somebody you have no idea who this person is, and they just show up this week for the purpose of you getting to bless them. So think about that. Think about all these different ways that we can give because it gives life to our souls. Remember, these pathways, these rhythms are for our good because God loves us and he's met all of our needs. And he said, hey, you can be content. And part of what brings contentment and joy is meeting the needs of other people. So let's go do that this week.